Hi guys, so we are back now. Rasam and appam. What we are going to do is now we are going to marinate this chicken. Okay, so I'll tell you the first marination, how it is done, and then we will talk about the second. So for the first marination, what we need is, okay, we'll take a bowl, okay, and we'll add all the chicken pieces that we need. Okay, just keep adding all the chicken pieces. Now once this is done, we'll add almost 2 to 3 tablespoons of lime juice. Okay. Then we will add some ginger garlic paste. I'm using the ready-made one because ginger is a little difficult to source ginger garlic paste during these times. Okay. Then we'll put about 2 tablespoons of 2 big tablespoons of red chili powder, and just mix all that up, and then we'll put salt. Okay, now once this is done, just marinate it nicely. You can see the ginger garlic paste and everything has to be marinated very nicely to all the chicken pieces that go inside. Now it's better if you're able to source fresh ginger and garlic, then please use that. Okay, because the other ginger garlic pieces give a little bit of an artificial taste. Okay, so it will give a better taste to your tandoori as well. Now once this is done, if you see, the masala should go all in, has to be marinated very nicely. But all this masala should not only go on one chicken like it is going right now, the red chili powder. Okay, let's mix everything up to all the chicken pieces properly, like everything. Okay, once this is done, we'll just clean this up and put this aside. This is the first marination. After 15 to 20 minutes, we keep this for about 15 to 20 minutes and leave it just like that. Okay, and I'll show you the second marination after that then. Okay, see you again. Hi guys, so we are back with now the second marination. So for the second marination, what we are going to do is take a kadai, okay, keep it on a little bit of high flame so that it heats up faster. Then we'll take some oil, about 2 to 3 tablespoons of oil, so that the next ingredient that we have, okay, can. And what we'll do is we'll just wait for a while, because then we'll have to put a bit of ajwain and some gram flour. Okay, what we'll be doing is we'll be adding the ajwain to it so that it crackles a bit. Okay, so let the ajwain, kind of, it has to get that aroma out. So when you feel that, you know, the little bit of crackling has started, okay, what we'll do is we'll add the gram flour. Now gram flour is basically about 3 tablespoons that I have taken, around 3 tablespoons. Okay, so we mix the gram flour. Now you see that while we are mixing, smells so good. Ajwain and gram flour is like a heavenly combination. Also, ajwain has its own, you know, health benefits. It's good for the tummy. Okay, so it stops you from any gassy problems. So that is why we add a little bit of ajwain along with this. Now, if you see, it has come together. We'll just keep on sauteing it for about 2 minutes. Okay. Now what we'll do is, once this is sauteed, okay, we'll just take this a bit down. Okay. While we take this down, okay,
put it off. We'll take it down to cool for a while. While we take it down, we'll add a little bit of haldi also to it. You can see turmeric. This is about a teaspoon. You can say half a teaspoon. Just mix it nicely. Mix it properly. This is done so that the haldi doesn't get too burnt or doesn't get that color too much to it. It just gives that flavor to it, turmeric flavor to it. So we'll just keep mixing it till it's done while it's hot. So if you see, everything is mixed really nicely. It has got that slight color and it's quite good enough. Now once this is done, what we'll do is, okay, we'll keep this aside. Now we'll move on to the chicken. For the chicken, we'll need some curd. We'll be putting a little bit of curd to it. Red chili powder, black salt, and a little bit of garam masala. So it'll be nice if your curd is nice and thick. So we'll not put a lot of curd. Maybe just like you can say half a cup or even lesser than that. Because while it's cooking, otherwise it will just, you know. So this is your curd. I mix the curd to it. Okay. Curd is gone. Then we'll add your red chili powder. So we'll add some more red chili powder to it. Okay. Now in goes your black salt, which is about quarter tablespoon of black salt. And your garam masala. Garam masala should at least be about 1 tablespoon. The better the taste, the more nice it will taste. Okay, so now what we'll do is we'll just mix it. While we mix it, this thing goes in. We'll even simultaneously add the gram flour paste that we have. Okay. It's quite hot. So just blob goes down. Okay. It's hot. It's very hot. Okay. Now just kind of coat your tandoori, all your masalas together. It's a beautiful taste. It gives a beautiful color. See, some people would even add some, you know, red color powder, but I'll just avoid it for now. Your family who you're eating it with, already there is so much of trouble in the air. We don't want some more trouble with your artificial colors, right? So it won't give you exactly the red color because we are not adding any artificial colors, but it will give you a nice, you can see, nice thick coat. So what we'll do is now we'll keep this for marination for about 3 to 4 hours, or whenever the next we are just, I'm going to fry it. I'm not going to bake it because it's my husband's wish to eat some fried tandoori today. Okay, so we'll be frying the tandoori and then we'll be making something out of it. Anyways, so that's about it. We'll be back for what's going to be done with this next. Okay, thank you. So we are back now with the marination. As you see that the chicken has been marinated. Okay, we are going to put this now, the oil is gone hot. Okay, we have taken about 3 tablespoons of oil. So we are going to put this in the hot oil. It will splatter a bit. Okay. We are going to put 2 leg pieces first. Okay. So now let this get cooked for a while. Okay, once it is cooked, we'll come back once again.